Hi, and welcome to EasyStats. Today we're going to learn how to calculate variance.
In the previous video, we defined variance as a measure of how data is spread out around its mean. Population variance is the true variance, but it's extremely tedious to gather data for an entire population. Instead, one can take a sample from a population and infer population variance by finding sample variance. To begin, we are first going to learn how to calculate sample variance. Sample variance is denoted by S squared. I will talk about why I chose S squared instead of S in a bit. To calculate sample variance, the first step is to find difference between each data point and mean. This difference can be represented as xi minus x bar, where xi represent each data point, which in our case is the weight of each individual Smartie, whereas x bar represents the sample mean, which is simply the average of our entire data, which is the weight of all these Smarties. Once we have found the difference between each data point and the mean, then we can add the squared results of each data points, which is represented by this. Here, n represents the number of data points. The square is important because it always gives us a positive answer for this difference. If we did not use the square, then some of the differences would be positive while others would be negative, and if we simply added them, they would cancel each other out and give us incorrect answer. And that is the reason we have to square them. Now you might think that the next step is to divide the expression by n, and that this will give you your sample variance, but this is not true. We do not divide this expression by n. Instead, we divide it by n minus 1. So dividing this expression by n minus 1 gives us our formula for variance. The proof behind using n minus 1 is out of scope of this video, but will be further discussed in future videos. For now, we will say that primary reason behind using n minus 1 is because had I divided by n, the sample variance would be an underestimate if compared to population variance. Now that we have our formula, we are now ready to calculate the sample variance of the Smarties weight. Here I've already added these numbers and found out the total weight of Smarties, and the number of Smarties is 9. The first step is to calculate sample mean, which is represented by x bar. To find my sample mean, I just need to divide my total weight by number of Smarties. So if I divide 9.8 by 9, I get, and this number is going to be same for all the data points. The next step is to find the difference between each individual Smartie weight and the average Smartie weight. We do this by subtracting x bar from xi. So for my first Smartie, I can subtract 1 by 1.0889. And that gives me. Similarly, I can calculate the difference for the remaining Smarties. Now, I'm just going to square these numbers so that they're all positive. So, 0.0889 squared gives me. Now I can do this for the remaining Smarties. Now, if you calculate the sum of these numbers, it will come out to be summation of xi minus x bar squared equals 0.04889 gram squared. And it is this number and this that we need to find a sample variance. So this gives me which is the sample variance of the Smarties weight.
We are now going to talk about population variance.
This formula is used to calculate population variance.
I have differentiated my population variance from my sample variance by using sigma instead of s. Note that I have used population mean mu, which is not equal to my sample mean x bar.
Mu is a representation of population mean.
For example, I would get my population mean if I could measure the weight of all the Smarties in the world and find their average. Note that I'm using n and not n minus 1, and this is the formula for population variance.
Did you notice that the unit of sample variance and population variance is always squared? This is because the difference between the data point and the mean is squared. In order to represent the unit as originally seen as a data point and not a square, we can find standard deviation.
Sample standard deviation is simply the square root of variance. And this is the reason why I denoted variance by s squared, so I could denote my sample standard deviation by s. My square cancels out my square root. So for our example, we can find out the square root of 0.00611 gram squared, and that gives me, in case of sample standard deviation, my units are not squared and my units match with the ones of data. But in case of sample variance, my units are squared. They do not match the units of my sample data. As you might have guessed by now, my population standard deviation, just like my sample standard deviation, is the square root of my population variance. The square cancels out the square root and it gives us sigma.
For your homework, measure your room several times and find the sample variance and standard deviation of your results. Remember, if you want to find out the mystery of n minus 1, tune in to our upcoming videos.
Thanks for watching EasyStats. Bye for now.